You know, sometimes God done things in a mysterious ways. In his own time. Sometimes I wonder myself, I've been here 24 years. We've been doing good things. But I don't know why this is now that is done on us about passion for souls. Of course, we've been working with pastors, seminars, preaching. I preach revivals here. You know, I got seminar here and there. So we work with children, we work with the needy, with the widows. But it's like God has done us now. This is, and I believe this is the best part. And this is our lives. This is our commitment. We are committed to walk in passion for souls. And I know it's going to be hard. And the devil will fight us every step on the way. But we trust God for passion for souls to help make a difference. You should hear what the pastors are, text they are sending me. They all look toward fashion for souls. We have not done much at all. Except they come here, like you. You came here for a week, 4 or 5 days. And you come, you pay. You cover, the cost cover. And we make a little money. But when they come, it's what we make on you. We feed them. They sleep here free. They eat in the morning, they eat at night. And at noon, we feed them 3 times a day. It's free. And if we try to charge them anything, they will not come. And some of them even ask us to help them for transportation to get here. They don't have it. They don't have the money. And I'm conscious of that. We are conscious of that. We know it. We do what we can. But what we can do is so little. And the task is so enormous, so great. It's like we do nothing. It's too big for us, but it was our God. There is no, I believe in my heart, there is nothing that God cannot do. Mm-hmm. He has done so great things in our lives. Mm-hmm. The fact that we are alive in Haiti, the Lord has been protecting us for the last 24 years in this tough country. God is great. Mm-hmm. He is marvelous. He is wonderful. Mm-hmm. And we are trusting Him. I don't care. We are ready to do anything that is in our power. Mm-hmm. That the gospel of Jesus Christ move forward. Mm-hmm. Souls, lost souls come to know Christ in a personal way as Savior and Lord. That churches been built. We are looking at having a bunch of seminary graduates, we are going to hire them as full-time employees. They will be working, we will have a chaplaincy program which will cover every prison in Haiti, every hospital in Haiti. We'll have them there to share Christ, to win people to the Lord. We are so grateful to the Lord that you are here tonight. And like I always joke, we don't want people to come too many times, except 100 times. And we want you to keep coming. We want every one of you at least to make one friend. As you go back, share with your family. It's good that, you know, there's nothing like coming and seeing it for yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, these folk that you see, they are much poorer than you think. On Sundays, everybody looks so nice. But they go home sometimes. There is no supper. Mm-hmm. Their kids cannot go to school. And I always tell people, passion for the, we are not concerned just about the soul. Bringing people to Christ is number one. But we need to feed them. We want to build a roof over the head of those who cannot afford to build a small house. We cannot change the life of every Haitian. We cannot send all the kids in Haiti to school. But it is more the responsibility. The kids were born in our churches. They are born there. They have been raised in our churches. And for them not to be born to go to school, get an education, that's shame on us as believers. And we feel we have a responsibility to at least the kids in our churches to have an education. And that's not what's going on now. Many of them will be raised ignorant, condemned to live in deep poverty because of a lack, of course, of the lack of a good education. There is work to do. It's not just souls, but it's the body. It's not just the soul and the body, it's the mind in your soul. So that it will become useful citizens who can contribute to for the progress of the kingdom of our Lord. The Lord count on us. I know he's not going to send money from heaven, although he could do that if he wanted to. But that's not what he's going to do. He's going to use me to do the best I can, to give the most I can give. It's going to depend on you and your family and your friend, your church, to make a commitment toward Haiti. The gospel of Jesus Christ is the hope for this country. I know that's the hope for the world. But it seems like Haiti is in top, on the top of the list. We are dying for help. We don't love money, but I love to make money. I would like to make money because we need money. Mm-hmm. Not for us, because we got enough today to eat every day. If we can eat and have a roof over our head, what else do we need? But the needs around us, we are surrounded with needs. And it takes money, big money, to meet them. We count on your prayer. We count on you to help us pray the word. Pray for passion for souls, so that the vision God has given us will become a reality in some day like today, when we all get to heaven. There will be souls from the north, the south, of Haiti coming and say, "Thank you, friend. Thank you, friend, for supporting passion for souls, that today they make it like us in heaven." Again, thank you for being here, and we are open for questions. If you have any questions, we'll be more than happy to try to answer them.